Hello everyone, today I am having an admission head of Kohinoor Business School, Mumbai. Hello sir, how are you?
Good, I'm good.
Very nice sir. And the first question to you is, why do you like to be in our educational sector rather than any other sectors?
Okay, well, that's a very good question. Normally, when you look forward to the education sector, when I graduated and when I completed my management course, MBA in 2004, and that time my all other friends went into different company and I joined my own college, Wellinker, from where I completed my MBA. And that time only, you know, the same question was there, what is in the education sector? But then, that time I realized one important aspect of the education sector, that where that time there was no facility to reach out to the student or just giving knowledge and all. When I joined my MBA and when I appeared for CET examination, I still remember I was not knowing that which are the management colleges, what are the courses, what happens after MBA. But I joined just to do MBA. I was not much aware. Then I thought, okay, why not this to take it ahead? And definitely that was one motivation for me to join the education sector. And definitely I'm really happy that I can make changes I'm just improving in thousands of people's life, because that is what exactly the job of education sector which is there. And that's the reason I like education sector and to be in the education sector.
Very nice, sir. Very nice. So, in being in such a good position or in education sector, can you say something about your key factor behind this successful career?
Key factor behind the successful career, almost last 16 years I'm working. I worked with various brands, big brands currently. For last 8 years I'm working with Kohinoor Education Trust, Kohinoor Business School and Kohinoor Management School. If we talk about the key success, of course it is, I cannot say hard work or something, but smart work. But at the same time, it is more important to have your honesty, loyalty toward the organization, and whatever work is given, if you are doing a justice to that work, then definitely nothing like it. But if you are not giving a justice to your work, there will be no success. That is one thing. And second aspect, a pass out student and to whom I counseled, admitted, and he got a good job, and when he calls me back on some Guru Purnima or some other day, and he says that, thank you sir, because of your guidelines, sir, because of this thing, I joined the college and you only counseled me for the, joining MBA and all. I was not thinking, and so now today I got selected in this company or I am at this position. That really keeps me motivating, and that is what the key behind successful, because looking forward to these people, and that gives me more and more to reach out to more students. That really helps the institute as well as for me as a personal branding.
Very nice, sir. Very nice. One great work you are doing, sir. And a third question to you is, what is the leadership skills you have in yourself?
Leadership skill, of course, it was a good question, because 2 years back when Kohinoor Group, our Kohinoor Group is little bigger than education, which has a real estate, three hotels, one is 5-star hotel, one is 4-star, one is 3-star. We have 200-bed hospital in Mumbai. Almost 1 kilometer land developed by the Kohinoor Group in the real estate. So they selected me as a leader, me in the leadership program 2 years back, and I successfully completed my leadership module with the group also. There I understood one thing: leadership is nothing but lead by the example. And that is exactly, if I start working, yes, it is going to happen. And from my side, if you ask me about my leadership skills, go getter. First, start yourself. Do not wait for others to this thing. And that is the only one mantra which I believe. Leadership means lead the way, lead the front. Because somewhere, when question comes about the positivity and all other different things also, but for me, the positivity comes through the success, and success comes through the leading and taking a risk-taking capability. See, leading means when person can lead a situation or a scenario or task or department, whenever thing, it is only when he has a risk-taking capacity. What next if not is this? And that, if you have good calculation of the risk, that what loss you can recover or this thing, then definitely you're going to get it. So for me, leadership, it is either you should have risk calculation and the capacity to lead in front. That is what I feel about the leadership.
Very nice, sir. And as you told me that you are connected with education sector since last many years. So would you like to say something about our Indian educational system?
Okay. Again, it's a good question, but here it is a little, when we think from the education perspective or education sector, this education sector in India or education system in India is something different, because somewhere we need to improve on practical aspects. Not only that, but at the same time, if you now you must be aware of new education policies coming up. There are so many changes are there, positive changes are there which are happening. But probably our university system, which is there of the changing syllabus in 5 years, 10 years, rather it has to be every year there has to be upgradation in the syllabus, upgradation in the training system. And most important aspect, now also I believe that the institute education system, where till today also the good people are not joining education sector as a faculty. And good means from the perspective of the percentage, because toppers go leave the India and go abroad. Even though now you must have heard that Srikant Datar has joined as a dean of the Harvard University. Of course, it is a proud thing. But at the same time, you would have been in India also leading, creating new Harvard here. But somehow, this kind of talent is moving out. But of course, we hope for positive through this corona and all this impact. People will start coming back to India, particularly when we talk about this current scenario, and of course, good future to the education system. Government, of course, investing a lot of efforts, amount and all, everything. But again, I'm saying that it is youth or people, parents also equally need to understand the education, understand the importance of the education to their child and kids. And it is not only, shouting parents and all. Here what we need to do is we need to really develop the complete ecosystem to the education. That is, because only teacher or school or college, not because equally parents also need to. It is not only that, I'm not talking about management education, all across education also parent needs to know that how much students to be burdened. I was just reading a joke, it was a joke or something, I don't know, there was someone has posted that my 2 month child, what need to do? It was a joke, but it is something like, someone is saying that, did I miss the coding competition? So that is what, because, and nowadays, when I see that, when, child is conceived, that time only they're thinking about the school admission booking and all, this is going little on upper side, but need to give equal importance to the child freedom, kids, other activities also. And this all, but of course things will improve. Of course it will improve because new education policy gives much more aspect like this. So we should hope for the best.
Yes, exactly, sir. As we are seeing that in advertisement, when a 6-year-old child is doing a coding work, I think it is not for me. Yes. I will not give a name of the company. Yes, but and yes. Next question correct, to you correct. Is, yes, sir. And next question to you is, sir, what is the best part of your institute which is different from another institutes?
Okay. So firstly, I'll tell you, the Kohinoor Business School started in 2005 in Khandala and shifted in Mumbai in 2010. Kohinoor Business School even started in 2005, but Kohinoor as in education is from 1961. Kohinoor Group's always the heart is lies in the education, because our founder, Dr. Manohar Joshi, who was the Chief Minister of Maharashtra and Speaker of the Lok Sabha in 1995 to 1998, he was the Chief Minister, and then afterwards he was the Speaker of the Lok Sabha. When he started in 1961 as a Kohinoor Technical Institute, from the one perspective only, that the people should learn and get jobs. 61, you imagine that time jobs and situation, scenario and education. So from that time it is started with education. We're still having this Kohinoor Technical Institute, almost more than 40 branches across India for the giving vocational education. And then at the same time, we started in education. education, we started a Koinu Hotel Management in Khandala. Since we had a hotels from 1976 onwards, we had a hotels and hotel business. So we started a hotel management. In 2005, we started with the Koinu business school at Khandala and shifted in Mumbai in 2010. Since then, this is the 10th year celebration, but due to Corona, we were not able to do it at the grand level. And otherwise, this was the 10th year celebration at Koinu Business School. If it comes to value or different, our USP of the Koinu Business School, I feel USP of the Koinu Business School is nothing else. It is a brand value, and that brand value came from my pass-out school. I'm proud to tell you, every year, every batch, there are 3 to 4 siblings, real siblings, are studying again with us. And that is not so easy, because many of them, if one brother or one student studies, his brother or sister studies from different college. But here, every year, this year also, in this pandemic also, proud to say that 6 real siblings, I'm not talking about the cousins and all, 6 real siblings of my pass-out students are studying with me again in the same program. And that is not long back when those are pass-out in 17, 18 or 15. And that is what the USP of the our college. Also importantly, when it comes to the KBS, PGDM and MMS, both the program, now after the AICT, the names have been changed. KBS has gone to the MMS and KMS is for the PGDM. In KMS and in PGDM also, we have Industry Immersion Project. And that Industry Immersion Project is something which is unique in concept, wherein students studies complete sector for almost 1 year. And from the module 2 itself, or trimester 1 itself, what student is studying about the sector of their choice. Like someone is interested in FMCG companies, or someone is interested in working into the banking industry. Now, when someone is interested in the banking industry, what is happening? That person who is interested in banking industry or banks, so what he is doing is completely studying bank or banking sector for 1 year, and then he finds himself a summer internship along with the help of the college in that similar sector, which helps him in understanding relating the theoretical aspect, theoretical knowledge with the practical aspect with the summer internship. And once he comes back, what we are doing additionally is we are again starting with the aptitude test, aptitude preparation. Because as you know that companies like ITC, Dabur, and this is all FMCG, JK Tire, MRF Tires for that matter, JP Morgan, Steel, all these companies are visiting our campus, Godrej and Boys, Tata Capital, Tata Consultants, and TCS, all these companies, Capgemini. So all these companies, what they're doing is they're conducting an aptitude test again. And for that student, need to be clear. And this is really a successful activity for us in 2015 when we started this activity. Probably for ITC, there were some out of 92, only 29 were selected. And this year, exactly ulta, out of some around 130 students applied for interview, 95 students cleared their aptitude test of ITC. Wherein that was the full campus at our own campus, wherein students from all the different colleges also joined in that. It was only KBA students where almost 80% students cleared the ITC aptitude. It is not because of any other thing, but it is a systematic approach towards the placement. What is happening here in this two years program? First year, as I said, gives more on the theoretical knowledge or book or conception understanding. Second year, the moment they come back, we are behind them about the placement, because at the end of the placement is more important, because all this course is for the placement only. And we are there because of placement, and this placement, like we say, placement drives admissions, admissions drives the academics, and again academics drives the placement. This is a cycle. And that is the reason these three people are very important: admission, academics, that is program head, and then placement. Because these are the three people those are pushing out the program, and that is the reason we give more focus on the placement in the second year. And the moment student comes, their GDPI preparation, their aptitude, and all these things, along with their industry immersion project. And also we have one more module called customized module. Customized is what exactly? Because by the time of fifth trimester, students get to know about which industry he wants to go. Because after his successful completion of summer intensive, like someone wants to go in banking sector, or someone wants to join the FMCG. Suppose someone wants to join FMCG, what is the need to teach him the financial subjects or banking at the fifth trimester? Because no use, because he needs to be taught something which is related to his own sector where he wants to go, and that is what the customer module comes there. We teach him only which industry he joined, because by that time our half of the student get placed or get offered, and then we try to pull them out in the same sector. That is what exactly the different aspect of the institute. That's what
very I think. Nice, sir. Very nice. So your institute is doing very great work, and after hearing that customization, it is very very well. Exactly. And another question to you is, what will be a main challenges for your institute in upcoming time?
The main challenge, if you ask me, the main challenge is how to recover this current pandemic and all, because what is happening, nothing to hide, but this year's scenario was at least somewhat good, but next year will be really a difficult one to the institutes. Reason behind that, next year placements will be definitely little low compared to all, because you know the current scenario, almost working half of the people are left with the jobs and all, and adding new talent also, it is little on slower basis. So this slowdown may impact on admission. Like, you must be aware about 2008 Lehman Brothers crisis, and the economy was down in 2009 and 2010, and in 2011 onwards again there was a bad days for the management institutions or all the engineering and all everyone. The reason behind that, see, but here I would like to tell you parents and students also what they are missing. Actually, they join when industry is up. They join when placements are good, but they don't understand that when you're, I'll give a simple example. In 2011 till I remember, many of the students had paid the donations to getting admission in EXTC department in engineering. When they passed out in 2016-17, Geo takes over, and the, you know the current scenario of 2017, and they're not getting jobs. They need to understand the cycle of the industry. Many of the people now this year also, they are not joining the MBA school, but they're not understanding after 2 years, economy is going to grow. So now you should be sharpen your skill, and you need to, but then this is what exactly the challenge to explain to the student and parent, that this is the right time to move towards education, because you do not have the jobs at graduation level. You do not have the good experience level. So better what you can do is, better you join as of now, currently concentrate on the MBA course, do the professional program, professional studies, and then once you complete your 2 years, that time, definitely in 2 years time, the industry is going to come back again. So that is what the exact challenge, to communicate this thing to the people. That is, and I hope, you know, people like College Dunia and you know, others, exactly would like, this is a challenge, and this is what we want. We want you people also, matlab, as a, you know, portal, as a being some responsibility toward the education system. We would like you people also to have a campaign. It is the right time to invest in the education, because what will happen after 2 years when the placements will be good, and that time you enroll again, then next 2 years we don't know what will happen. So, you know, that exactly, matlab, you know, I mean to say, this is what challenge I feel. Sorry, this is what the challenge I feel towards the institution. Yes, that's it.
Very nice, very nice. And the last question to you is, as you are working and counseling students from last many years, so what would you like to say about the youth of India, and any advice for the current youth of India?
Okay, for youth of India is something, you know, they need to plan their career. This is very, very important aspect. And many of the time, I know that what is happening, because, you know, it's a generation to generation gap. As of now, if I ask how many members are there in Lok Sabha, many of them, 90% of them, they don't know what is Lok Sabha. Then if I ask someone that who is finance minister, they say it's politics. But they need to understand that this is not a politics, this is a governance. Because at the end of day, we are bound, and we are abide to have the policy. We should have understanding. We should have study of the sector, like politics also. Not, I am not saying politics. It is a governance or civic. Because knowing finance minister, knowing RBI governor, it helps to understand the policies of. Because being a professional course, or be it in professional or not professional, so you should be able to understand the economic aspects. Even though you are a teacher, you are the farmer, you are in the working into the company, you are a businessman, you have shop, you have whatever business, whatever, you should know the economy, how trends economy going and all. And this is all possible where you, what you need not to do much things about. Instead of reading page 3 of this Bombay Times, better you read page 2, page 1 or 2. That will really help us. Of course, when it comes to the electronic media and all, and particularly my appeal to the Indian youth also, please stay away from the news which are out there on WhatsApp, Facebook and all social media. News, please verify with the newspaper only. The reason behind newspaper has some, they are bound with some act. If they are giving some news, they need to give some proofs of that. They cannot write like anything in newspaper. So that, please see to it that, you know, this is my appeal to youth. And please look forward to know who is your governor, what are the policies, what are the interest policies. This will really help you to manage your own budgets. You manage your own advances, loan systems, your deposits, everything. It will be really helpful. And if you are going for the management education, you need to have this all aspect. That's what my message to the youth.
Very nice. So small message is just like, if you do not understand the governance, you do not have to blame government.
Yes, correct. That's
it. It was the last question, and now we are ending our interview. Thank you so much for being a part of this program.